Hello everyone, welcome to another video on the channel. In this video, we are going to be converting contour lines like these to create a 3D topography like this. Now, if you're trying to draw or model a building on an on-level surface, contour lines will help you to have a somewhat more accurate representation of the surface to which the building is going to be built on. So stick around to the end of this video to see how I do this in AutoCAD using only one single command. If it's the first time on the channel, thank you for stopping by. Feel free to scroll down and hit the subscribe button. And if you actually learned something, give this video a thumbs up as it will help the video to reach more viewers like yourself. So let's go. So this is what a topographic map with contour lines look like. A bunch of lines with some numbers on each line. Each contour line indicates ground elevation or depression. If the numbers associated with specific contour lines are increasing, like these here, the elevation of the terrain is also increasing. Now, if the numbers are decreasing, like we see here, then there is a depression in the surface. For example, in this image, we're looking at a plan view of this section of property. The numbers that we see for each contour lines are representing the height or elevation of the surface from a known reference point, also known as a datum. So this contour would be 40 meters above main sea level. This one would be 60 meters above. Likewise, this one would be 80 meters above. The closer these numbers are to each other, the more accurate and refined your topographic map will be. That means we will get a more accurate surface in AutoCAD. And with that said, I have a question for you. Where do we get these contour lines from? Or how do we as designers and architects get this sort of information? Of course, this is something you would usually get from a surveyor. He or she would be able to provide you with a CAD file with the contour lines and property boundaries in all its glory. Now, this information can also be retrieved from a civil engineer if there's one working on the same project that you're also working. Other than that, there are some websites that you can retrieve contour lines from, such as cadmapper.com. I'll drop the link for this website below the like button. This website will give you general topo of anywhere in the world. Guys, if you're enjoying this video so far, would you do me the honors and hit that like button for the YouTube algorithm? And without further ado, let's jump over to AutoCAD and I'll show you how to get this done. So here we are in AutoCAD architecture, and the command we are going to use today has been around for a long time. So even if you're using an older version of AutoCAD, no worries, this should work just the same. And so let's see what we can do here. Now, the first thing you need to make sure is that you have your property boundary and your contours all set up and ready to go. You may need to obtain that file from your surveyor or civil engineer, whoever it is. And you may also need to clean up that drawing, because of course, a lot of times that drawing will come with a lot of other things that you don't necessarily need to create your surface. And so you may need to clean it up so that it looks like what I have on my screen here or somewhat similar. Now, of course, on some diagram, you will have a lot more contour lines, even outside of the property, and that's fine. Also, on some property, you may have fewer than what you're seeing here. And so it all depends on your scenario. Anyways, what you're seeing here is something that I cooked up for this video. And so this is not done by a legit surveyor or a civil engineer. And so if you want to do something like this for yourself, you can, using polylines. It's important that you only use polylines, okay? So when I say polyline, this is what I'm talking about, this guy right here. The other thing you want to make sure is that each line is on its separate elevation. So if I rotate this in 3D view, you can see that each of these contour lines are on an elevation by themselves. And usually this is how you would receive it from the surveyor or the engineer. And that's very important in order for AutoCAD to be able to generate these surfaces. And so right away we can see, or we can get an idea of what the surface should look like. And so that's how that looks. So let's go back to the plan view, and we're going to go to this drop down here, and we're going to go to the drape command. So this is the command that we're looking at. If you're not seeing it in your AutoCAD, maybe you're using the wrong AutoCAD. What we can do also is to type the command in the command line, drape, and hit enter. The next thing we want to do is to select our contour lines. So all of these yellow lines here, and then I'm going to hit enter once more. Now, do you want to erase your contour lines? The answer is no. And do we want to generate a regular mesh? Now, I like to use the regular mesh. If you want to explore the irregular mesh, then you can do so. But for this video, we're going to stick with the regular one. And then next, we need to draw a box around the property or around the area that you want to generate this surface for. So I'm going to do something like this. And then we need to define how smooth we want our surface to be. And the higher this number, the more smooth it is, and the lower, you know, the more jagged it will be. But for the X direction, we're going to stick with 30. And for the Y direction, I'm going to also stick with 30. And then finally, it asks us how thick do we want the base to be? And I'm going to stick with 10 feet. Enter. And just like that, you can see that we now have a rectangle around the property. Doesn't look like much would have happened. But if we should rotate this in a 3D format, we can see that we have, you know, some elevation. We also have some depression and all that good jazz that we spoke about earlier. Now, if we put this in a realistic mode, you probably can see a little bit more of the shadows. This property is a fairly gentle slope, so nothing too crazy to see here. But just so you have an idea of what this looks like. So when you have your surface created like this, now you can model more accurately against this surface. Your drawing will be more representative of what the actual site looks like. And so that's very important when you're doing drawings that need to exist on a sloping piece of land. So what would it look like if I were to add a building to it? And I do have something over here to show you guys. And so this is what it would look like. I have featured this drawing on the channel before. So if you want to see the time lapse of this, I'm going to drop that link below as well. But yeah, as you can see, having a sloping land can give you a lot more flexibility and allow your creativity to flow even more. And so you can, you know, do a lot more with what you're given. The last thing I wanted to show you guys is that this is a mass element in AutoCAD architecture. And so with a mass element, you have all the additional tools that you can use. And so one of the cool things I wanted to show you here is how to trim away the parts of the property that you don't necessarily want. For example, what if we wanted to trim this away so that we only have the property itself? What we can do is use the trim by plane command at the top here. So I'm going to click on this, and then we're going to select our first point on the property here. And then right away, it allows us to create a plane. And so I'm going to click on this second point of the property to finalize my plane. So now that I have my plane, what I need to do is to select the side that I would like to erase. You can see it being highlighted in red when I move the cursor from one end to the other. So I want to erase this side. I'm going to click, and just like that, that side has been erased. So I'm going to do the same thing again three more times to get rid of the other sides. And so just like that, we now have a topo surface of exactly precisely just the property in question. So if this is something you are interested in doing, I know there are some scenarios that would require you to do this, but in general, you know, I typically we'll just leave it like this. And especially for this scenario, I think this looks much cooler than to trim away all the stuff, because I wouldn't be able to add these extra tree and water and all that good jazz around it. So that's it for this video. So let me know, what questions do you have for me? Let's hang out in the comment section below. If you learned something, go right ahead and hit the like button. Subscribe if you haven't done so already. Shout out to my patrons over on Patreon and YouTube members for your continuous support. And guess what? It's easy to plot property bearings in AutoCAD. Check this video to see how that is done, or watch this one right here that YouTube thinks you will enjoy. See you guys in the next video. Boom bang.